Hi everybody, another request today, and it's on my Dirt Devil Featherlite Bagless. The original Featherlite Bagless, not the rebadged Breeze sold in stores today, or whatever other names that crappy style went under. I believe when this came out in 2000, it was the middle-of-the-line Dirt Devil, I want to say, if I'm even correct when it came out, because of course it had the Breeze, which was probably their lowest, and I think they still sold the Vision or some sort of it at that time. I believe this was what was their kind of moderate series, and I think they should have kept it because it's a nice, decent vacuum. It's not pathetic like the Vision, and it's not extra pathetic like the Breeze. And it's not bad. And don't know if I didn't say it or it wasn't realized, but I have two of them. The green one I got first, and then I got the red one after that. Green one came from my old neighbor across the street. This was the first of two vacuums that he threw out. The second one was my bag Power Force, which I believe is in video number two. Only thing wrong with this one was for some reason he busted off the brush plate and the brush roll was missing. This vacuum withstood 7 days in deep snow because my mom refused to let it in the house. This was back when I was actually allowed to bring vacuums in the house occasionally. So I've had this one for a while. But anyway, so yeah, I did that, and then it made its way to the garage, and then it defrosted, and here it is today. Works fine. So it's been 20-some bucks on the brush plate, brush roll, new belt. Replaced the HEPA filter because at that time I thought it was actually important to replace filters. Washed the inside one, did a thorough clean through the port on the back. This thing here that needed to be cleaned out. There was a bunch of junk stuck in there. Didn't come with any attachments. Over time I've acquired all the attachments for this one, and this one just needs the telescopic wand. Again, I acquired all the attachments. This one, I don't think there was anything wrong with it. It might have needed a belt. Other than that, it was in perfect condition, minus missing the height adjuster thing there, which I was given from the vacuum store. This was also the vacuum that came with my Encore Supreme. Sometimes I forget that, but yeah, my mom picked up the Encore for me because I tried to convince her I was going to sell it, which I never did because I like it so much. And I came back the next morning before school at like 5 in the morning and dragged this home because I wasn't going to let it go to the trash. And the cord that I ended up getting for it is this nice expensive 40-foot cord from a Cibo. My wasteful buddy at the vacuum store, I asked him if he had any used cords I could buy, and he said, how long are you looking for? I said, I think it was a 25-foot. He's like, well, I have a used 40 here that is practically brand new that you can buy for, that you can have for $5, and you can cut it down in size. I'm thinking, well, if it's a 40-foot cord, why would I bother cutting it down? I got an extra 15 feet. And here it is. I mean, it still has the sticker on it. It says $30, and he's, just because it was on a vacuum, he's selling it used for $5. And like, you are that wasteful. I mean, you could have gotten away with selling that new, and you could have put it on somebody's Cibo. But anyway, I believe, actually for some reason I plugged them both in, but I'll only be running the green one because I like it more. I'm going to get the red one out of here. Something told me to plug it in. I don't know why. But I'm going to run the green one. It's also funny because like, I haven't used this thing in a very long time. And because it has the swivel wheels, I'm expecting it to fall over like the Vision. Well, I know what else I was going to show you. Very absent-minded tonight. The replacement in the brush rolls. Get it over here. The difference in brush rolls is what I was going to show. You see, this one has the original plastic, double row, kind of swerved, or whatever you want to call that, where it kind of moves across. And this one has a very weird patterned, expensive wooden roll. I've never seen a weird pattern like that. think it was some, I think this was some weird aftermarket brush roll that the vac store I went to bought. Didn't get this from my normal vac store. But yeah, you can see the difference in replacement and original. So now that I remembered that, we can run it without wasting any more of everybody's time, if I am. Otherwise, oh well. Okay. I think if they would have gotten rid of the stupid swivel wheels, it would have sold better if it didn't sell good. I don't exactly know about that. Another thing that like kind of bugs me, which isn't really a problem, is like this hose is like flimsy. It moves around all the time. I hate that. They should have made that pathetic little hook there a holder for it. I hate like crap sticking out. That's why I like Hoover's design of the, you probably can't see it, the hose that went around on the elites and whatnot. So yeah, I think that's it. Not bad vacuums. Brings back a little nostalgia, I guess, in using it, because there was a very thick layer of dust on these when I pulled them out. Hope you enjoyed seeing them, and keep asking for the videos, I guess.